What's that one costly promise that you make that your customers will never forget or forgive you? It's a trap that we set for ourselves, and in this week's video, I'm going to share with you how to avoid that. Hey there, it's Michael Creasa here, the executive editor with Agent Inner Circle from agentinnercircle.com. Welcome to this week's video, and it's about that costly promise that you make that your clients will never forget. Now, before we get into that, please, as always, move your thumb over a couple inches and give us a big like. Click that mouse, give us a big like, leave a comment, and by all means, share this video. Now, what's that big promise you say? Well, let's go back a step. I got my license back in the 80s. That's when I started selling real estate. And that was long before laptops, PowerPoint presentations, cool color graphics. Now, I'm not saying that we chiseled everything out on slate, but the presentations that we did back then were somewhat lacking to what we have today. Okay. So the first thing, though, I remember my manager, broker manager, going with me on my first listing presentation and the theatrics involved. Kudos. You know, it was the art of selling, if you will, the art of selling. And I remember we got in there and he paid them a compliment, asked for a glass of water, and then directed everybody to the kitchen table and then went into his presentation. And as I said, there were no graphics, no visuals. He had a sheet of paper and he had the MLS catalog. And after about an hour of flipping through pages, showing them comparables, writing down some notes, he got to the climax, which was the price, because the sellers want to know the price. So he reaches into his pocket and, like a magician, makes his business card appear. And then he pulls out this beautiful Mont Blanc pen. Oh my gosh, authority. It just speaks of authority and credibility, beautiful gold pen. And then on the card, he writes down the price, flips the card over and slides it to him. As a matter of fact, he gave me the pen because it was my first listing presentation. Still have it today. That was showmanship, but here's the thing. That was around the time Floyd Wickman, Mike Ferry, Walter Sanford, all these cool cats that basically revolutionized real estate training started coming onto the forefront. Latter part of 70s, early 80s. And I remember that was around the time that the cool listing presentation started popping up. And the one that stands out was the 21-point checklist of the things we do to get your home sold. So every time you would list a home, you'd pull out this 21-point checklist and share that with the seller. They would go, oh my gosh, look what I'm getting for the commission. Well, what does your competition do? If you got 21 things, well, of course, they're going to offer 50. And then you find out they've got 50 things that they're offering. What do you do? Well, I'm going to offer 75. It's like an auction. And it got to the point, and I kid you not, 121-point checklist when we list your home. 121 things. Oh my gosh. It was like, you know, the secretary's putting fresh coffee on the pot. We're putting paper clips in the office. Whatever it is, 121 things. Well, do you know which one thing the sellers always remembered? And it was a costly thing. You know which one that was? Take a guess. No, not that one. It's the one that you didn't do. The one that you forgot to deliver. You could have done 120 things perfectly, but you forgot that one thing and now you're labeled. That goes right to your credibility and to your trustworthiness. You want to avoid that at all costs. You know how you do it? It's very simple. Here it is. You may want to take out a pen and write it down. Under promise, over deliver. Oh, Michael. That sounds so simple. Yes, it is. And some of the best things in life are simple, especially in sales. Under promise, over deliver. Hey, Mr. and Mrs. Seller, remember I promised I was going to do those five things when we listed your home? Just want to let you know, you can check those five off the list. And by the way, we also did number 7, 8, and 9. Under promise, over deliver. That goes to your credibility. It's like making a deposit in the trust credibility bank in your name. You want to be referable? You want to be credible, under promise, over deliver, your clients will love you for it. Don't get caught into that trap where you have to make so many promises that you'll forget what they are. Under promise, over deliver. It's that simple. Please leave us a like and comment. Michael Creasa here, executive editor with Agent Inner Circle. Hope you found this video insightful and it will help you with your real estate practice. Once again, give us a like, leave a comment. Take care.